Good morning, my friends. So today is June 5th, 2014, and Matthew's in the kitchen again, and he's making us breakfast. And so it's my day off today, and we always sleep in on my day off anyways. But again, I did it again. Like, by the time you see this video, like on the last vlog, like I said, I forgot to buy something for hamburger soup today. But then for the video that you saw already, when I made that chicken curry, oh my gosh, I forgot it was summertime and I was melting and sweating as I was making the stir fry. I'm like, why do I do this to myself? I'm like, I'm not doing that again. Cause it is finally summertime now, so I bought this one thing the other day finally to finally make the tomato soup. This tube of tomato paste. But I decided against that. I don't want to be sweating again in a sauna. And so I switched to making pizza. And then I bought stuff to make pizza. And then the one most important thing, and I forgot to buy cheese. And like, really? And so we have to get some cat food and dog food today too anyways, right Matthew? So we're going to go out to do that. And so, have to do laundry today too. And have to work on uploading the videos because the computer room is so hot. My main PC that I used to upload the videos, so hot. I just can't stand sitting there for too long. So do the laundry and upload some videos for you guys. And I'll show you breakfast. So, in the laundry. And what I normally do is every 3 or 4 days that I got day off, we've got these laundry bags. So we fill it to the brim. I fill it to the brim. That's the way I do it. And so we got this, on our laundry machine, we got a super function. It takes a little bit longer, but I think it helps save water, and we have to do less loads of laundry. So that's the little part we can do to help save the planet, I guess. So our laundry machine's pretty good. It takes in that big bag of laundry pretty good. So in it goes to there. Oh, from the Home and Garden show that we went to, this last one, they gave us a free bag of this Nelly stuff. It's actually very interesting. They say they give me the free bag, so I picked it up and I didn't even ask or anything, but they actually have a little tiny spoon. They include a little tiny spoon in here. Which is very interesting. It comes like this. I hope you can see how small it is. And it says, use one spoonful of Nelly's laundry soda for each load. Wash according to instructions on garments. Always test on garments that may bleed or fade. And it doesn't tell you to use more for larger loads or whatnot. And so I've tried it once with just that one spoon and the similar side load last time. It works. It doesn't smell like anything. It's laundry soap. It works. So yeah, that's what I want to share with you. I forgot to show you the weather for this week like I normally do. Because the weather, they keep on changing their minds every day. Like, today is a little bit cooler. It's sunny with a little bit of clouds on a high of 13. It's the low 20s. And so we are going out to do a few things here and there. And today is Thursday, and so it's garbage day for us. And it's very entertaining to see the way some people fills up their garbage bins. Because we have those new, it's not too new, it's like these few years now, we've got these automated garbage trucks now, so they don't have the guy at the back anymore at every house and reaching for the garbage bins or whatever. It's all used the automated arm, and if you just drive down the boulevard here, you're gonna see a lot of entertaining ways how some people fills up their garbage bins.
Oh, and there's the garbage truck right there.
Oh, there's the garbage truck, see?
Automated arm goes
see,
out.
See, it's that automated thing we got now. It's that arm. They shake it like 3 times. That's how it is. So, what are we doing today? We're gonna go Walmart to get a few things, and we're gonna get some pet food, and we're gonna have to exchange our CO2 can over there, because you can do that. Any entertaining garbage bins filled up here?
Not on the street today. I know on our street there was some that were overflowing a little bit.
And like, I don't know, like, you're not supposed to put extra stuff on the side anymore, because technically they're not supposed to go out of the vehicle to put it into the truck anymore, but some people still does that. But so we're headed out and we'll show you whatever exciting thing that happens next. Oh, like, we were wondering what were happening to the blocks of cheese there. We were thinking they got rid of the thicker block.
No, that was somebody.
Is that our usual cheese that we buy?
Yeah.
Showing you the shopping cart we got. I haven't had this crab meat for so long. We are good for next time. Next we're gonna hit the freezer aisle, and we're gonna get those sausages we got last time. Have they been Matthew approved? Those breakfast sausages,
no.
Matthew?
No.
What?
No.
Oh yes, they have. You like them. And all we came for was just cheese, guys, and look at what's growing here already.
That's huge.
It's supposed to be our breakfast sausages, the $8 package. All gone, empty. Aww. What we came for is all empty.
Aww.
But yeah. So what are we gonna do? Do we have any more bacon? The price of bacon is not much better,
way
is
too
it?
Expensive.
Oh well. We're survived with hot dogs for now. Alright. I didn't know that they came up with this with the lemonade and mango. That looks so good. The Walmart brand of juices actually came out with a lot of stuff, hey? I didn't know they had that much stuff. Oh, only Walmart sells this one now. The regular grocery stores took it out. The blueberry watermelon. Can I get that? It's 2-something. Oh. So we're done at the Walmart over here, and we did way more damage than just the cheese that we were coming for. And it's really weird, like every McDonald's that I go to, these like for the similar stuff that I get them do, they seem to charge different things. Like I use that coffee cart that they got like on the side of the cups here, and the sticker is there, and so it's only redeemed for a medium, but you can ask them to upgrade to a large cup of coffee. And so the one McDonald's that is near our house, and I upgrade to the large coffee, only charged me 25 cents, but this McDonald's over here charged me 42 cents, so I don't know about that. So if you guys are not interested in these free coffee stickers, you can hook me up with some of these stickers, okay? Just kidding, I don't know. The 1-800 free coffee, call that, and we can arrange we can arrange the details about that on how to send me those stickers if you don't want them. just don't throw out don't throw out your cups. It's like a waste of money. It's one thing. Why are you coming to Tim Hortons? Are you getting something at Tim Hortons?
I'm getting something at Tim Hortons.
It's the 1-800-FREE-COFFEE. You hook up Calvin with some free coffee stickers, the unwanted stickers. And so the treat that Matthew got at Tim Hortons, he's being truly Canadian here. He got the ice cap. Like, Matthew is not like a real coffee drinker. Like, I don't think that's real coffee they use. Well, it's the coffee syrup, is it?
Yeah.
And so...
coffee gives me heartburn.
Yeah, Matthew gets heartburn from real coffee.
So that's why I don't drink it.
So Matthew got the ice cap, ice frappuccino.
Ice cap.
Ice cap. Oh, yeah, that's Starbucks. I don't know. I rarely go to Tim Hortons. I don't know why, but there's the Tim Hortons. Yum, yum. And I got my coffee. So we just used our 20% off coupon at Bed Bath & Beyond to exchange for the CO2 cartridge over there. And, then I got hooked on this new Tic Tac stuff. It's the green apple. And the Bed Bath & Beyond is the only place that I'm able to find this stuff at. I just bought a bottle a few weeks ago and I'm already low on it. Because, I don't know, I'm not really too crazy about their other flavors besides their mint one. And
those aren't like Tic Tacs though.
These are like the
softer than regular Tic Tacs.
But these are really yummy. I really like these ones. I can eat these by the handful. These are really good. Yum. Okay, so we got a little haul to show you guys. We went to a few places, but we didn't buy too much. But this one is the soap. It's in the dollar store. It's $2, so just under 2 liters. When we showed it to you last time, it actually lasted us a long time. So that's that. And then... we got a package of paper towel and $3. It's not like it's a good price or bad price, but whatever. And then I showed you these Tic Tacs from Bed Bath & Beyond. And then, Matthew, could you put these in the freezer, please? We got this crab meat from Walmart. The stuff here. So usually I take one half of the package out and use it right away and put the other half in the freezer. These are great for omelets, salads, stir fries, whatever, you name it, you got it. And then this other stuff we bought here, it's for cheese. So we bought a block of cheese, so put that away right away. We got that, and then the rest of the stuff was, we got some grapes. We got some grapes from Walmart. They actually looked pretty nice, and we bought some bananas. They were like 57 cents a pound at Walmart, so we bought some of that. And I didn't realize Walmart had their own brand of chocolate bars as well. And so, where's my other chocolate bar? This one is their almonds with dark chocolate. And, yeah, where did my other chocolate bar go? Huh.
You had two there.
Where? Oh, did he put it with the sausages? Oh. And there's the one with the crispy rice milk chocolate. That sounded different, so that's why I bought that. And these were on sale, and these chicken wieners. These are good for like stir fries, fried rice, whatnot. And so, yeah. And so that's the haul. Oh, and at the pet shop, we bought a bag of dog food, kitty litter. Matthew, can you open that bag up, please?
The inside of the bag.
We bought some cat food. Our cat likes this stuff. This is the cheap stuff. like turkey and stuff. Like, our cat is very weird, don't like the fish flavors. And, this is very funny. Even Matthew found it funny. It's this new dog treats we found. It's the dogs, Oreos for dogs. Okay, so Matthew, show. Hold the camera. I'm gonna test it on the dog. Ebo!
So you're gonna eat it yourself?
Ebo, sweetheart. See, they actually package it.
Ebo!
They actually package it exactly just like Oreos. Ebo, sweetie pie.
Waggle, 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 waggle. He's like wagging the tail going, what's going on?
Oh. Okay. Sit.
Yeah, that was good. Sit. Where's the sit?
Sit. 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 And hand. Shake hand. Kissy. And then you get a treat.
Oh, so much for watching that. He's gone.
He likes it. It's been approved.
Thank you, Kelvin. That was really nice of you.
So now, we're getting ready for dinner time now, and, this is the dough. Matthew, because I think when they first ticked it out on the shelf, it's frozen, but it thaws out on the shelf, so we don't have to worry about the freezer, the thawing out part, in the directions.
Leave the thaw on the counter for 4 hours.
No, it's already all thawed already. So, it comes in a package like this. So one dough in the bag is one pizza. So I've never tried this type of dough before. And all the salt and stuff is added in already. So yeah. And we're gonna make a cheeseburger, buffalo cheeseburger bacon pizza today. And that will be on a separate video upload, and I'll show you the finished look of the pizza, of course. So we are testing out this pizza dough today. So now Matthew, my assistant, he's my pizza assistant here. So the instructions on the bag is for when it's frozen, but the store sells it thawed for you already. So you don't have to worry about the frozen instructions part. Just take it directly out from the package. It's very, very convenient already, I think. Hey, and you actually get the full product around from it, right, Matthew? You don't waste, no waste. Let's see how easily this product comes. I think you had to grease the pan there.
No, you don't have to grease the pan. It's got enough already in there.
Oh, does it have grease in it already? Okay. Pizza dough product actually came out pretty clean. You actually get the full product.
Yeah.
You don't have much waste or anything. What does Matthew say about the greasy? That there's oil.
Well, there's already oil already in the dough.
Show your hands. Show. Does your hands look greasy?
No.
But it stretched out nice. So now I'm just getting set up for the video recipe here.
Yeah.
Really? For tonight's dinner, I make the buffalo chicken, not buffalo chicken, buffalo cheeseburger pizza. And so it will be on a separate video upload, a recipe upload. But man, this recipe was like, because I had to buy bacon bits and we didn't have any bacon at home to make bacon bits. So this two pizzas took an entire tube of this stuff, and the hot sauce, I opened up a new bottle. This was, it used half a bottle of hot sauce, but you keep it in mind that I used it for the two pizzas. So, and that pizza dough stuff I showed you earlier, it actually turned out pretty good, and it smells like the frozen brand of that stuff that I was trying to imitate, that I was trying to make. It really is the copycat version of the frozen one. So it's really turned out really lovely. So I think I'm going to call this vlog today on June 5th a day. Done for the day. Right, Matthew?
Yeah.
So the next one I'm probably gonna do, the most exciting thing that's happening, is my brother's graduation. So I'm gonna be showing that, but that's not in a few days. So here's the pizza tonight, and I'll see you again in the next video. Thanks for watching.